Welcome to Souvenir, this is Fredo. So I'm going to present the functionality of Souvenir, which is a productivity plugin, companion features that can be useful when playing with SketchUp. So here is the toolbar. So the first two icons are for the history of previous models. So this one, for example, open the list of previous models. Unlike the native SketchUp, it's not limited to 9 entries. Then you have a task list, pretty much like Google Keep, if you know it. So you have two types of task list. One is for the model itself, so the data are stored in the model, or for SketchUp, so therefore the data are shared with all models and by the way all versions of SketchUp. You have a small utility which is to locate the plugin folders. As you can see, sometimes, and especially on Mac, it's not so easy to find a plugin folder and to open it. So here you can open the plugin folder easily. And the last one is a favorite. So it's a list of links which can be file, folders or URL which you can call at wish when you are in a SketchUp. So for example, if I click here on Google, I open the Google web page. The history of models so can be called by clicking on this icon. So here you have the list of previous models. You have a preview of the model as well. So let's open this one. So as in SketchUp, you are asked whether you want to save or not the current model. So let's say no. So the new model is open. So Souvenir also provides this icon, which is to recall the last SketchUp model. So if I click on it, I go back to my previous model. This can be useful when you start SketchUp and want to resume your work with the model you had when you exited. Souvenir maintains two task lists. As said, one is for the model and one is for at the level of SketchUp. So they are identical otherwise. So let's open the one for the model, which is displayed in yellow. So as in Google Keep, if you are on a task and you type return, you open a new task. Okay. You can delete task by clicking on this icon. You can also select a task to be shown as done. Okay. As you can see, when you delete a task, it's not immediately deleted. It goes to the done tasks and it's indicated to be deleted. So it will be deleted when you save the changes. So now it's deleted. Otherwise, you can reorder the tasks by clicking on this icon And you can also move a task to done like this. One thing you can do is to print the task list, or export it either to text or CSV. So pretty simple. A few details on entering tasks. So this icon will open a new task at the top of the list and this icon at the bottom of the list. Okay, so if you need to have a task on several lines, you need to press Control Enter to enter a second line. On a Mac, I think it's Alt, the true Alt Enter instead. Okay. When you put a task in the task done, you can of course undo it and put it back to the open task. So I think that's all for task list. Favorites is a convenient way to keep files, web URL or directories easily reachable. So let's open the favorites. So here I already populated with a few favorites. So you have typically three types of favorites: URLs, folders, and file. So you can create a new favorite by clicking here, and let's choose a file. So let's take an RB file, and I create. If I wanted to create a folder, then I would have, for example, selected this folder, and just create it instead. So now I have it. So just to launch a favorite, you double click on it or you press enter. So here is the folder which I have defined. So as you notice, the favorite list closes when you open a favorite. You can maintain it open by clicking on a small pin icon. You can edit a favorite. So if instead of Google you want to put SketchUp, okay, you can do it. By the way, favorites are stored at the level of SketchUp or can be stored in the model. So they will appear only if you open the model where they have been defined. So if I click local to model, now you see the difference. SketchUp is in blue. Otherwise, you can delete favorites. So same strategy. It is marked for deletion and you can undelete it. And if it is deleted, then when you exit and reopen, it's not there. And last thing, you can sort the favorites either by name or by type. Okay, so URL usually come last, or by last usage, that is whenever you open a favorite, it goes on the top of the list at the next opening of the favorite list. I think that's all for favorites. Plugin folder can be useful In some circumstances, although it's fairly technical, so you click on this icon and you have the list of the plugin folders. In my case, I have actually two directories because I use additional plugin folder so to define alternate directories. So same simple if you want to open it, which for example on Macintosh is not so easy, you just double click on it and you have the list. One small thing is that can be useful as well. They are in the path for loading RB files and plugins. Actually, there are more than the official directory. There are a number of technical folders that you can also display and which are here indicated in the order of loading. So you can show them or hide them. Souvenir is distributed on Sketchucation under a license model. However, the license is completely free. So the first time you install a Souvenir and without licensing, you will see that in the various functions of Souvenir, you will see two things. First, limitations. So here for the history of SketchUp models, there is only 9 entries maximum, and you see a yellow button license. Similarly, for the task list, you are limited to 4 tasks. So if I try to add a new task, I get a message to tell me that I need to obtain a license. Same button, license. For favorite, same thing. If I try to create a favorite beyond 4 favorites, I get a message. To license Souvenir, I need to click on the button License. I get a dialog box managing the license for Souvenir. So at this stage, it is empty because Souvenir is not licensed. So to obtain a license, I click on this button, Obtain License. I go to the purchase page of Souvenir on Sketchucation. You may have, depending on what you have done, you may have to log in to Sketchucation before you get to this page. All you have to do is to click on the free button, the license is free. Enter your email address and click Get License. So you will receive an email from Sketchucation with the purchased license file. Now let's switch to my email. As you can see, I receive a mail from Sketchucation about the Souvenir plugin license. So I get in attachment the purchase file, license file for Souvenir, as well as a PDF containing some instruction. So what I need to do is to download the file and put it in a safe directory. So switching back to SketchUp and the license dialog box, I just click on Validate License. I retrieve the purchase license file, double click on it, and as you can see, I'm now licensed for Souvenir. So the license is free, and I have 5 seats which means of which one is already taken by this computer, I can install it on four other computers. Now, if you open a tool of Souvenir, you see that there is no longer a license button and you have no limitation. You can create freely a new favorite or add a new task. So thank you very much for your attention. Enjoy SketchUp and see you for next plugin.